Oh, that alarm clock. Oh. Whoa, it sure is a nice day to read my Bible. We're to read my Bible, review scriptures.
No, no, don't read that. Put your head back, sleep a bit. You can read that later.
Boy, I sure am tired. I think I'll take a little...
Aaron!
Aaron, awake thou that sleepest. Rise from the dead. Christ shall give thee life.
Oh, yeah, I need to read my Bible.
I can smell the aroma of fresh eggs. Mommy's making breakfast. Hear your tummy growl, boy. It's time to eat. Put the Bible away. You can read it later.
Yeah, I can read my Bible later. I'm gonna eat, man. I sure am hungry. Whew.
Harry, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. That's what Jesus told us.
But I'm hungry and my stomach's growling. I think I'm going to eat first this time. Oh, look at those deviled eggs. Oh, man. Captain Crunch.
That's good, boy. Keep eating. And by the way, look at your watch. You better hurry. It's time to go to school.
Oh, no. I got to go to school. I'm going to be late. Oh, no.
Aaron, walk in the spirit, Aaron. Oh, watch and pray. Walk in the spirit, Aaron. Don't be in a hurry. Take time for Jesus.
I think I want to read my Bible. Oh, man, it's too bumpy on this bus. I can't read my Bible. Well, home from school. Oh, yeah, that must be my friend. He said he'd call me at school. Hello? Oh, yeah, I forgot. Okay, I'll be over there in just 5 minutes, okay? Goodbye. I'm going to go to my friend's house. He asked me to go swimming in his house.
Read the word, Aaron. Read the word.
But I'll do it after I go swimming. Well, I'm home now. Might as well read my Bible. I have nothing else to do.
Aaron, just don't forget. It's time for television. Why don't you watch your favorite show? You can read your Bible later, boy.
My favorite TV show, yeah! Turn it on. Oh, man, look at that, guys. Listen to his guts out.
Oh, yeah. Turn away my eyes from beholding vanity. Set no wicked thing before my eyes. Seek first the kingdom of God.
Oh, yeah,
read the word, Aaron. Read the word.
Oh, it's too bad it's over. I gotta read my Bible now. I said I'd read my Bible before.
No, boy. You don't have time for that now. Don't forget your test tomorrow and all of your homework. Time to do homework. You can read the Bible later.
No, I'll get in trouble if I don't do my homework. I better do my homework.
Aaron, you haven't read the word. Seek first his kingdom and he'll bless you. Your grades will even improve. Hide the word in your heart.
But I need to do my homework first. I'll do it after I do my homework.
No, I've got a better idea. You're much too sleepy now. Why don't you just go to sleep, do your homework in the morning? You can then read your Bible
tomorrow. I'll wake up early in the morning after I do my homework. I'll read my Bible.
Tomorrow you can read your Bible. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Sleep.
Later. Tomorrow.
Aaron? Tomorrow. Today is the day of salvation. Watch and pray.
That's right. I haven't read my Bible all day today, and I haven't prayed. Oh, no, I better pray and ask Jesus to forgive me.
No, don't do that.
Dear Lord, I pray that you'll forgive me, Jesus, for not reading my Bible and listening to the devil. And Satan, I rebuke you right now in Jesus' name, and I command you to leave in Jesus' name.
Don't say that.
In Jesus' name.
That's right.
I'm going to read my Bible.
Amen.
About putting God first, and we want to give a little object lesson of how to do so. And I want to challenge every one of us today to remember this little motto, no Bible, no breakfast. Remember that, no Bible, no breakfast. Be sure and read your Bible before you eat your breakfast. Matthew 6:33 says, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." Here I have three golf balls and a jar, and little Evie's holding some beans for me. Well, what do these represent? The jar represents one day in your life. The golf balls represent God and His Word and seeking the Lord and having time with Jesus. The beans, they represent all the things that we do in a day. And you see, if we don't put the beans, the golf balls first, let's fill up our day, see what happens. We fill up our day with getting up in the morning, going to work or going to school, and we come home and maybe we eat dinner and we sit down and watch a little TV, and all of a sudden our day is almost full, but what did we forget to do? We forgot to put God in our day. So just before we go to bed at night, we try to stick the Lord in at the end of our day. Does He fit? No, He does not fit at the end of the day. Where should the Lord fit? He should fit at the beginning of our day. Let's try that, shall we? Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Let's put the Lord first today. So here we seek God in the morning. Oh, I don't know if we'll have time. I don't know. We spend so much time with the Lord memorizing our scriptures and praying. Do you think we're going to have time to do all we need to do? Let's see. Bible says if I put God first, I'll have time for everything else in the day. And you see, it all fits into place perfectly. You can top your day off with a little prayer, and everything will fit in place if you seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. All these things shall be added unto you. I also want to say a thank you to Coach Dennis Clark, who has the ministry called Jumping for Jesus. He goes all over the world, and he inspires young children and all ages to skip rope. And this time, we're going to have Mary, who's age 5, and Evie, who's 7. They're going to attempt to skip rope to all the books of the Bible. Shall we do that? We're just about to see a skit to show how we must be transformed. We cannot be conformed. We must be transformed. Amen? Do you agree? Take the Word of God and transform your mind. Otherwise, we might end up living in an old man's rubble like this gentleman.
Are you trying to take them upon yourself? If you are, then you're living in bondage, and you know that's bad for your spiritual health. And are you trying to live by your emotions? Are you putting your faith in what you feel and see? Then you're living just to satisfy your passions, and you better be careful, 'cause you're being deceived. Are you living in an old man's rubble? Are you listening to the Father of the world? you're behaving? Do you wonder why you do the things you do? And are you troubled by your lack of resistance? Do you feel that something's got a hold on you? With deep within you, there's a spiritual battle. There's a voice of the darkness and a voice of the light. And just by listening, you've made a decision. 'Cause the voice you hear is gonna win the fight. Are you living in an old man's struggle? Are you listening to the father of lies? If you are, then you're headed for trouble.
Worldly goods, step right up, get your worldly goods. I've got everything in life to make you happy. Fame,
Mister,
fortune, happiness, worldly goods, step right up.
Mister, what do you got there?
Worldly goods, boy.
Will it get me a job?
Will it get you a job, sonny? You take this little ticket right here, and in 2 weeks, your name will be at the top of the ladder.
Yay!
Yay! Worldly goods, come on, step right up.
Hey,
who's next?
Will they be skinny? Will it make me a movie star?
Dear, will it make you skinny and a movie star? You take this little card, and in 2 weeks, you'll need to gain weight, and your name will be in lights from Broadway to Hollywood.
Yay!
Will it get you a fancy house with fancy cars? You'll have a big house, then a driveway just full of sports cars.
Yay!
Mister, will it make me happy?
Will
it make me happy?
Will it make you happy? Well, temporarily, yeah. Worldly goods, step right up.
Hey, will it keep me from going to hell?
Keep you from going to hell?
Yeah.
These are worldly goods, dear. Now, come on, we can't give you any kind of guarantee like that. Worldly goods, who's next? Step right up.
Will it take me to heaven?
And what about Jesus?
Hey,
how about eternal life?
Can I take him with me when I go?
These are worldly goods. No. You need my worldly goods to be happy.
No.
Hey, what are worldly goods?
What are you doing?
They're no good.
You're throwing my worldly goods on the floor. Worldly goods, come back here. You need these worldly goods to be happy. Worldly goods. What about you? Would you like some worldly goods?
In Revelations 3:20, Jesus says, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hear my voice and open the door, I will come in unto him and sup with him, and he with me."
Well, it's another day for me to do some dirty tricks to some Christians. Where is my assistant, Doofus? Doofus, where are you? Where are you?
Here I am, Buff. Here I am. Here I am. How you doing, Buff? What can I do for you now, Buff?
Well, I've got an assignment for you.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. An assignment. An assignment.
Quiet.
Okay.
Well, here's what I want you to do. I want you to go over to Billy's house. Yes, Billy's house. And I want you to whisper some things in his ear. Whisper some nice things in his ear, Buff? No, not nice things. Remember, you're the devil. You're supposed to lie. So whisper some lies into his ears. Yes, in his ears, not his eyes. Listen, here's what I want you to tell him. Yes, Buff, I'm listening. Tell him to start making Pac-Man his hero, to spend all his time at the arcade, and he'll be real good and everyone will like him forever. Tell him that, and that way he won't spend all his time reading the Bible anymore. I'm tired of Jesus being the hero. This time we're going to make Pac-Man the hero. Ha!
Okay, Buff. I'm off. I, Capitan. Here I go on assignment. Yep, yep, yep.
Ha, 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 ha. Yes, let's see what happens at Billy's house.
Boy, Lord, I just praise you and I worship you for everything that you have done for me. And Jesus, I just love you. I thank you for dying on the cross for me. And I thank you that I can pray. In some other countries, they can't even pray, or they might get caught and get sent to jail. And I thank you for the freedom that I have to pray and to worship you. And I praise you, Lord. And in the name of Jesus, I command you, Satan, to leave in the name of Jesus. Hey, hi, Billy, how are you?
Oh, wow. Man, I'm doing great.
Well, what's this new T-shirt you're wearing? It doesn't look too good.
Oh, this is my new Pac-Man shirt. Yeah.
Pac-Man.
Yeah, I took my Jesus shirt off.
Why?
And I put this Pac-Man shirt on because, well, now everybody likes me because I'm real good at playing Pac-Man.
But don't you think that's a waste of time and money? You could be helping people or reading your Bible or doing something creative.
Well, yeah, but you see, now the boys, they're buying me bubble gum now because I'm so good at Pac-Man. I'm the hero. I'm the hero now.
But Pac-Man. Really, have you read your Bible yet today?
Well, I haven't had time for the Bible today, you know. I have to keep practicing all the time because I'm the best.
Well, Billy, you should read your Bible every day. I mean, think of how your soul and your spirit feel. You haven't been reading your Bible. You're starving your soul.
Well, I'm just busy right now. That's all, sis. I'm just busy. I just don't have time for all this. I just don't have time.
I'm going to go outside.
Man, my sister just doesn't understand. I'm popular now with my new Pac-Man stuff. Man, that's how it is. It really is good. I love Pac-Man. I just don't have time for my Bible. Yes, and you're going to get more famous, too. And I'm going to get more famous, too. Yeah, I'm going to go down right now and play some more Pac-Man. That's where I'm going right now. Oh, boy. More Pac-Man, yeah. More Pac-Man, yeah.
Boy, I'm really worried about Billy. He keeps playing Pac-Man, and he doesn't have time to read his Bible or anything. I'm just going to pray for him right now. Dear Lord, I pray that you'll help Billy. Help him to come to know that Pac-Man shouldn't be his hero, but he should make Jesus his hero. And I just pray that you'll answer my prayer quickly, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Oh.
Oh, no. Sounds like Billy.
Oh.
Hey, Billy, what's the matter?
Oh, I'm just not happy today. Leave me alone.
Well, what's the matter? I'd really like to help you, Billy. What happened?
Oh, it's the arcade. I went to the arcade.
Yeah?
And they got a new game in.
Oh, really?
And nobody wants to play Pac-Man anymore, and that's the only one I'm good at. Oh!
Well, Billy, you know, the Bible says that we shouldn't put our mind on temporary things, but we should store up treasures in heaven. You know, the Bible also says that thou shalt have no other gods before the one true God, which is God in heaven. Because that's one of the Ten Commandments. Did you know that? And the Bible says to let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. You know, wearing this T-shirt advertised the devil, really. Because Pac-Man is not a Jesus.
Remember, there's no devil. Remember, they told you that. There's no devil. But, sis, there's no devil.
Oh, yes, there is. And I can tell that you've been listening to him. In the name of Jesus, Satan, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. No weapon formed against me will prosper. The blood of Jesus covers all our sins.
Wow.
And you know, Billy, I think you ought to pray and ask the Lord to forgive you for wasting your time on these things that are just temporary and won't last.
Yes, you're right, sis.
Let's say a prayer.
Okay. Dear Jesus, I'm sorry that I put Pac-Man before you. From now on, I want you to be my Lord. And I'm not going to wear this old Pac-Man T-shirt anymore either. And I'm going to read my Bible. I repent. And I love you as my Lord and Savior, Jesus.
Let's go get you a Christian T-shirt and be a light for Jesus.
All right. Let's go get me a Christian T-shirt. Come on, sis.
Okay.
All right. Oh, great. All right. Yeah.
Oh, hide the word. Where am I going to hide the word? Oh, I'll hide it in the refrigerator. Yeah, in the refrigerator. Nobody will find it there. Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Hide the word. Oh,
Johnny,
where am I going to hide the
Johnny,
word? I've got to find a good
Johnny,
place to hide
Johnny,
the word.
Johnny,
huh?
Do you know you can't hide anything from the Lord? You couldn't hide it under the refrigerator. Nothing from the Lord. The Lord can see everything.
I'm just trying to obey the Bible. The Bible says hide the word. So I'm trying to find a good place to hide it. Excuse me. Hide the word.
Hide the word means to hide God's word in your heart.
Oh, you mean like in my heart? Oh, I know what you do. You eat your Bible, right? Yeah, then it gets down in your heart. Yeah, where's my Bible? I'm going to eat it. Let's see.
No, wait, Johnny. No, you don't eat your Bible. You know, your mother wouldn't like it if you tried
I guess
that's not the way you get the Bible in your heart.
Hey, well, I know what you do. You go to the hospital, they put you on the operating table, cut your heart open, and put the Bible in. Yeah, I'm going to get an operation.
No, Johnny, no. Oh, no, Johnny's really mixed up.
My mom said that was too expensive, that I couldn't get an operation, but how do I get God's word down in my heart then?
Johnny, you know, to get God's word in your heart, you have to memorize it.
Memorize it. What's that big long word mean?
That means to know it by heart, Johnny, like you know your ABCs.
Hey, I know my ABCs. A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Oh, Johnny, you just keep
going.
Johnny.
Huh?
You need to know God's word by heart. Wait a minute. We don't want to sing the ABCs anymore. Yes, the ABCs are very good, Johnny.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to teach you a lesson.
Okay.
We need to memorize God's word.
Memorize God's word.
Know it by heart.
Just like I know my ABCs.
Johnny, wait. That's right. Shh.
Sorry.
The only way to learn is to listen.
I'll try to listen.
You know,
I won't talk no more.
You have two ears and one mouth, and we need to use them in that proportion, right? Okay. So, Johnny, we need to memorize God's word, and we need to learn it by heart so that we can say it in our sleep, and we can know it so that when we really need it, we'll have it.
You mean that's why I memorize God's word?
That's right. It says in Psalm 119:11, this is the verse you heard and you didn't hear the rest of it. You know, you need to stop and listen to it.
I do need to listen more.
That's right. Thy word have I hid. It sounds like that's as far as you listen.
Yeah, I thought I was supposed to hide it somewhere.
Thy word have I hid in my heart.
that I
might not sin against thee.
Who said thee?
The thee is God. And you know,
God,
we don't want to sin against the Lord.
No way. That's why I'm going to hide God's word in my heart.
That's right.
That's a good idea.
If you didn't know that it was against the law to speed, ooh, you might get a ticket.
Yeah.
Well, if you don't know God's word, you might sin against him. You might be sinning and not know it if you don't know God's word.
I don't want to do that.
No,
I don't want to sin against God.
No, we don't want to sin. So, are you going to start memorizing some of God's
word? Yeah, I'm going to go memorize some of that God's word right now.
Okay, why don't you start with Psalm 119:11?
All right.
Thy word have I hid in my heart.
In my heart.
That I might not sin against thee.
That I might not sin against thee.
Psalm 119:11.
Psalm 118:51.
No. Psalm 119:11.
Psalm 119:11. Hey, I said it. I did it. I hear God's word in my heart. All right. Yeah.
That's good, Johnny. I think Johnny's going to do good.
My son, give me thine heart. My son, give me thine heart. My son, give me thine heart. My son, give me thine heart.
Of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down strongholds, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
No, Titus 3:5 says, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy he saved us. You know, in today's world, everything is works and wages, and a free gift is almost unheard of. But we would like to show you just now how simple it is to receive the free gift of eternal life through Jesus Christ, presenting the gift. Good morning, ma'am. How are you? I'd like to share a free gift with you, eternal life through Jesus Christ.
Free gift, eternal life. That's cute. Who are you, Santa Claus or something? Can't you see I'm very busy today typing wages? Today is payday. Are you some sort of organization or something?
No,
maybe
just...
Maybe my boss could help you out. Maybe you can make an appointment. Some other time, maybe.
Yes. I just want...
Let's see. Yes, maybe he could help you out. Maybe you can make an appointment
for
maybe... Our working hours are 7 o'clock and 8
you.
O'clock at night.
A free
for
gift.
Me.
Yes.
I don't accept free gifts, thank you. There's the door.
You know, that secretary, she wasn't very receptive. I think I'll go over to the university and see how the students receive this free gift.
Yeah, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, A. Come in. Yeah,
work the week. Hi, good morning.
Education.
How you doing, student?
Money. Yeah.
Could I just have a moment of your time to share this free gift with you, eternal life through Jesus Christ, and it's got your name on it. It's for you, whosoever will.
Eternal life. We both know that nothing in this world is free. You don't sound very scientific.
No, but it's by faith. It's not something you figure out in your mind. It's a free gift. See, a gift is something you just don't necessarily deserve, but
well, never seen one, have you?
Sure. Jesus is real. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever, and he'll come in your heart. All you got to do is ask.
Yeah.
And believe.
Has my name on it, huh? What kind of trick is this? One of those scientific tricks? Hoaxes, yeah. That's what it is.
No.
Hey, let me measure it. Here.
Wait, you can't.
Yeah. Here, let's see, about 9 inches by 6 inches. Yeah. Okay.
The length, the depth, the breadth is immeasurable.
Yeah. Huh. In the bowl? Yeah, okay.
No, you can't measure the gift of God. It's immeasurable.
Doesn't compute!
Wow, that student, he wasn't very receptive either. Let's go down the street and maybe we can knock on a few doors and maybe some housewife would be receptive to this free gift.
Hello?
Hi, may I come in just for a minute to visit?
No one is allowed in my house.
I would just like to share with you this free gift, eternal life through Jesus Christ. It's
free
for you.
Free gift! Eternal life! I can't wait till this life is over. I have all these little runny-nosed kids to take care of, and my husband, man, he gets so mad when the chicken's burnt, and you're just standing here offering me this free gift. What is this, a sweepstake or something? I never win anything in those sweepstakes.
No, this is eternal life, Jesus Christ, the Bible. You know, it looks like the children are interested.
What? Go to your room. Go to your room right now.
You know, it's for whosoever will. Would you like to have it? All you do is pray, relieve, receive.
You know what? While you're standing here talking to me, my chicken is getting burnt right now. And then my husband is going to be mad when he gets home. Goodbye!
Huh. Oh, that poor housewife. She wasn't very receptive. I feel sorry for her and her children. I'll go downtown and talk to the businessmen. The Bible says, let's not be weary in well-doing. So, Lord, help me as we go downtown and talk to the businessmen.
Get to work. Got him late. What are you doing here standing right in the middle of the sidewalk?
Oh, excuse me,
sidewalk,
sir.
Don't you know?
Yes, excuse me. I'm sorry. I bumped into you. I've got something I'd like to share with you. It's a free gift. Eternal life.
Free gift. Come
Jesus
on.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ. We both know that nothing in this world is free. We have to work for it. And you're making me late. Time is money.
Well, this is more important than time or money. You see, this gift, the Bible says, if you believe, you receive, and it's yours forever. Eternity, eternal life.
Eternity? I gotta get to work now. Wait, this little gift is just holding me up.
Yeah, well, it'll give you something to live for.
This little gift won't help me or anything.
Sure, well, it'll give you something to live for.
What if it's tax deductible? Anyways, here's a quarter. Go get yourself a drink of coffee and a newspaper, but above all, get yourself a better job.
This has been quite a day today, hasn't it? But you know, we still have that free gift. We want to share it. I think maybe I'll just go over to the playground. Maybe, just maybe, the little children will believe.
Hey, mister, what's that in your hand?
Is it somebody's birthday or something? I wish it were mine.
You mean about this gift you're talking about?
Yeah.
This is eternal life through Jesus Christ.
Really?
Have you ever received him?
I don't think so, sir.
Would you like to pray and receive Jesus and have this free gift?
Yes.
He'll forgive our sins. Let's hold hands and say a prayer. Jesus, come in my heart.
Come in my heart.
And forgive my sin.
And forgive my sin.
I receive this new life.
I receive this new life.
The gift of God.
The gift of God.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Wow! Thank you, Jesus!
Wow, Paul, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
We've sure got some nice wells here, don't we?
Let's have a drink.
Yeah, let's do that.
Good water.
Nothing like that river of living water.
That's right.
Pure stuff.
Let's keep our wells clean.
Yeah, we've got to do that. You're right.
Oh, hi.
Hello.
Where are you going?
I'm going to the dump.
The dump?
Yes.
Why, the dump is that way. Two
Where
blocks.
Where are you going?
Where are
On
you taking
right.
to the dump?
Heavy Metal Records.
Heavy Metal Records.
Rock and roll.
Why are you getting rid of that?
Because I met Jesus as my Savior, and I'm just, this is all trash, and I want to get rid of it.
Hey, that's
good.
That's,
go ahead.
That's expensive stuff. You don't want to be wasteful.
Here. Yeah, I do. I want to throw it away.
That's all right. Let me.
You don't want it.
Just a little bit.
If it's wasted, then you better get rid of it.
You know,
it's not good for
you. A little bit
won't
hurt. Thanks, man. It's a long way to the dump anyway. Let's see what's going on here.
Highway to hell. Whoa.
Hey, wake up. Hey, you. Hey, that stuff's not good for you. Doesn't talk about God. Doesn't teach you anything good.
Can't hear you. What? Hey, man,
that stuff isn't good for you.
Oh, hey, it's maybe a little bit loud, but it wasn't too bad.
Which way to the dump? Hurry,
the dump. The dump is that way. Okay. Two blocks.
Hey,
don't stop.
What you carrying?
Well, this is just some cable TV and questionable videos.
Cable TV and questionable videos?
Yeah.
Hey, look what it says in Psalm 101, verse 3.
Wow.
It says, I will set no wicked thing before my eyes.
You know, we need a little entertainment once in a while.
That's what I'm trying to do. No, I'm trying to get back to God. I've been watching all this stuff. It's really polluting my mind.
That's right. It's not good for you.
It's a long ways down there. Hey, just a minute. Let me take it.
Well, no, I don't want to pollute you, too.
I a little bit never hurt. Hey, I got the word. I'm okay. Thanks.
You asked for it.
Don't you think that'll hurt your well?
Hey, did you see the video?
Hey,
did you
don't
see
tell
the...
me. I don't want to hear it.
Let me tell you what I saw.
You want me to remind you about the verse? I will set no wicked thing before my eyes. Hey, wake up.
How far is it to the well?
How far to where?
To the dump.
The dump? The dump two blocks that way, on the right.
Hey, what you carrying?
Just some juicy gossip.
Juicy gossip? That's a long ways. Here, I'll help you.
Sure?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, don't you think you shouldn't be into other people's things?
Well, I gotta know how to pray for people, Paul.
Well, you don't have to know everything about them.
Did you hear about Pastor? Did you know that Pastor was the other day? Did you know?
Don't tell me.
They told me that he was.
No, I bet you half of that stuff was lies.
Hey, what are you putting in my well?
Well, I thought this was a dump.
The dump? That's my well. Look, the dump's down there.
The dump's over there. What are you doing?
Hatred and jealousy.
What did you put in there?
Hatred and jealousy.
Hatred and jealousy? Hey, go on.
Oh, it looks like this.
Man, really messed my well up.
I told you your well was getting dirty.
What did you do to my well, Paul?
I didn't do anything.
Look, yours is clean. Mine is all messed up.
I didn't do anything. It was all those people. You took their stuff and put it in your well like it wouldn't hurt.
It's not so bad. I told you we can handle it.
Okay, you think it's so clean? Why don't you try and have a drink of it?
I'll show you. It's just like it's always been.
And I'll have a drink of mine, too.
A little bit of this stuff never hurt anybody. You gotta have some fun once in a while.
Living
water.
Ooh. I told you.
It's terrible.
I told you it wasn't good for you.
Oh, my Lord.
See, that's why we say don't put bad things in your well.
Just a little bit, even?
Uh-huh. That's just like you reap what you sow. Whatever you put in is gonna come out.
Oh, my Lord, forgive me. Help me to take better care of my well.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
And that's what you need to do, too. Keep your heart clean. Don't put bad things in. Put God's word in your heart.
From the grave. you know how to get to heaven from here?
Heaven?
Well, sure. You just go down that road until you reach the highway. And then once you get to the highway, you take a right on a loop. Or is it to the left? Well, at any rate, you're supposed to go down the main street. And then once you go down Main Street, you see this big church. You can't miss it. Once you find this church, or is it a synagogue? Or maybe it's a mosque. Oh, well, I'm sure it's in that direction. Or is it that direction? Well, it doesn't matter. I mean, it really doesn't matter what difference it makes. I mean, what direction you go. Anyways, after all, I'm sure any road will get you there. I think. I bet you think I don't know how to get to heaven from here. Well, I'll tell you this, okay? I've been living here for years, and I've done everything there is to do. I've seen everything there is to see, and I've been everywhere there is to be. I mean, look, if I don't know how to get to heaven from here, then nobody does. That's it. Nobody really knows how to get to heaven from here.
Then how will you get there?
Well, I'm sure when the time comes, I'll know the way.
But in the Bible, it says, small is the gate, and narrow the path that leads to eternal life, and only a few get find it.
A few find it? That's so unfair!
Have you ever looked for it before?
Well, I really didn't think about looking for heaven from here. I mean, really never set my mind or anything.
In the Bible, God says, whoever shall call the name of the Lord shall be saved. The reason why people don't search for God is because of their sins. He also says, all have sinned and fallen short of God's glory.
That's terrible!
But the good news is, Christ died for sins, once for all. The righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you close to God. You know, you see, Christ died for our sins and then rose from the dead to bring you to eternal life.
So, what do I do?
Well, the Bible says, believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved. Do you believe?
Yes, I do believe.
Well, let's just say a prayer.
Dear Lord, please come into my heart, Lord. I know you're my Savior and you're my only way to heaven, Lord. I thank you for that. In Jesus' name, amen.
Do you know how to get to heaven from here?
Let's see. You take this street through town until you hit the main highway. Then you loop around to the right. Or is it to the left? At any rate, you need to go down Main Street until you come to this big church. You can't miss it. Once you find the church, or is it a synagogue? Well, maybe it's a mosque. Oh, well, I'm sure it's in that direction. Or is it in that direction? Well, it doesn't really matter what direction you go, does it? After all, I'm sure any road will get you there. I think. I bet you think I don't know how to get to heaven from here, do you? Well, let me tell you, I've lived in this town for years. I've been everywhere there is to be, I've done everything there is to do, and I have seen everything there is to see. So, if I don't know how to get to heaven from here, nobody does. That's it! Nobody really knows how to get to heaven from here. Yeah!
So, how will you get there?
Well, when it's time for me to go, I'm sure I'll know the way.
Small. You know, the Bible says, straight is the gate and narrow the road that leads to eternal life. And only a few find it.
Only a few? But that's like so unfair.
Have you ever looked for it?
Well, no. In fact, I never really thought much about how to get to heaven from here before.
Well, in the Bible, God also says, you will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. But your iniquities have separated you from God. Your sins have hidden his face from you so that he will not hear.
That's terrible!
But the good news is, Christ died for your sins once and for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you to God.
Well, so what do I do?
Well, the Bible says, believe in the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved.
Oh, wow. Well, I'm really glad I know how to get to heaven from here now. Yeah.
Up here and share Ephesians 6.
Finally, my brethren,
be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For he wrestles not against flesh and blood, against principalities, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Therefore, taking to ye the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand the evil days. Having done all, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, having your breastplate of righteousness, feet shod with preparation of the gospel of peace, all taking the shield of faith, that ye may be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication, watching thereunto for all perseverance and supplication for all saints.
Amen.
We have kind of a funny skit now. I think both of you are going to really like
it,
and all the children are going to like it. It's a funny skit about this boy that has a problem because he had all these like idols and things in his heart that he put before God. And that could happen to any one of us. It's probably happened to me, and I know it's happened to you and me, and it kind of hurts, doesn't it? But it's good to get these things out of our lives and to get closer to Jesus.
Yeah.
So let's watch that skit now.
Okay.
Oh no, nurse! Another slow day!
This is not a slow day! No patience!
No patience! Time. Nothing to do! What are we gonna do, nurse?
I don't know!
Wait a minute, I think I hear some footsteps.
Yeah, me too!
Oh, no! Help him, nurse! Help him quickly! Sit down, be seated! Oh my! What is wrong with you, son? What's wrong with you? My heart! Your heart? Oh, nurse, quickly! I think we must operate immediately! Oh, if not sooner! Cover him up! Quickly! Oh, anesthesia, nurse! Anesthesia! Ah, this should take care of it! Ah, he's out. No problem. Okay, now, scalpel! Quickly! Scalpel! Ah, this will do it. Okay, operation! I think that's it. Okay. Oh my, look at what that did. Can you believe that?
Oh my God.
Do you see what I'm seeing?
I think I see what
I don't believe my eyes.
I think I see. We have to move.
Junk food.
Oh.
Terrible. All this stuff. Junk food. Junk. Too much junk food. Oh, I don't believe it. You see what
I
see? Oh, too much TV soap operas filling up his heart with all that bad stuff. He'll never make it like that. He's got to get some good Christian TV in his heart, you know. Oh, I don't believe my eyes. Bad music. Terrible music. Oh, he's kicking. He doesn't want to let go. Stop him. More anesthetic. He won't let go of this one.
Every time it works.
Pull it out. He didn't want to let go of his bad music. Hung up on that rock and roll, you know. Oh, terrible. Oh, and look at this. Wow. Last but not least, I don't believe it. It's terrible. Oh, but it's true. All of this leads to a... What, nurse?
Heart of stone.
Heart of stone. He's hardened his heart through all that bad music and bad movies and all that stuff. And now, we took out the bad. Always, we need to replace with good, yes?
Yeah.
You agree? Okay. Agree. How about a little bit of what? Peace?
Peace, yeah.
Put that in there. And a little... Love, yes, and always, joy, yes, joy,
yes.
Okay,
joy.
And last but not least, some Jesus, he's the best,
Jesus,
of course, always Jesus, and now, the operation is complete, sew him up, nurse, quickly, okay, now, remove this cover, and wake him up. Sit up, son. Tell them, how do you feel?
Wow, I feel great. Doctor, what do I owe you?
Absolutely nothing, because when Dr. Jesus performs an operation, it's absolutely free.